Alright, so instead of including this side quest to the rest of the side quests recording videos that I have for, you know, for my playlist of this region, I'll make this one a separate video. The reason for that is because for those of you who are interested in getting either the Horns of Monument achievement points, or if you're interested in getting God working amongst Mermortal, you might be interested in doing this quest. So, you know, I'll put into the separate video just for your convenience, so you can easily have a look at through my playlist or any other playlist or whatever. And it's called the Peak of Darkness. Now, this one will make you hunt for a black moa, which is, you know, sort of like a an object in the game, and you can charm them. And once you charm them, you will have the access of leveling them up and display them into the Horns of Monument achievement. Onto the monument at the Horns of Monuments, and in return, you get the points for your Guild Wars 2 account. And so, for the Black Moa, you need to do the quest for that before you can actually get the pet yourself. And it's for under the Friendship or Companion Monument or something like that. I can't remember on top of my head right now, but yes, it's for under Friendship, if I remember correctly. Or companion, either one of those two, but it's it's only one monument for that. And you know, that monument is for displaying all of your, you know, companions. Say I have my heroes right here, my heroes, I have Kors, Jura, blah blah blah, and then if I upgrade them with my, you know, with a special token, which I will explain in a separate video for that, if you upgrade them with a token, you can get a new armor for them. And once you get a new armor for them, you can display them onto the Horns of Monument, onto the monument at the Horns of Monument. And so, you know, for every single upgrade that you make, you are allowed to to display them, and at a certain point you get points for that. So at when you display, I think when you display about one of them, you get 1 point. And then if you display one rare pet, which is the Phoenix, which was the one that I had, I got about, actually this might be a good time for me to just show you the monument as well, so you can have a look at it. Oh shit. This is the Ashura Gate to go to the Eye of the North campaign, and also the location has the same name, Eye of the North. And where is the, yep, this is the Horns of Monuments. And it's where you will be, turning in your achievements, points, whatever that you have, so that you can get points that you can link to your Guild Wars 2 account. Now, this one is for Devotion, which is like for the miniatures. I think the maximum that you can get for them is about 40 with one rare. And I think that you need to have one unique. Rare is a gold miniature. The unique one is a green miniature. It's called Fellowship. It's not Friendship. It's called Fellowship. Alright, cool. So I have my marks. I have animal companion. So if you display just one pet onto the monument, you get both of the points. So animal companion, and also the specific pet itself. So I have the Imperial Phoenix. Now this one, Imperial Phoenix, I got it from killing Shiro Takashi. After you kill Shiro Takashi, you will be transferred to a special location. And once you got that into the special location, you have to equip your ranger spell for charming the animal. I don't have it with me at the moment because, you know, I'm having a mesmer. But I will change that into the ranger later on once I finish this quest, because when you finish this quest, the black moa will be available for capturing. So until then, you have to kill it first, and once you kill it, you have the option to the black moa will be available for capturing, but you have to go back to the place, you have to zone out the zone and come back. So yeah, for the Imperial Phoenix, I had to get her to level 20 before I can display the Phoenix onto the Fellowship monument. And for Mox, it's already available. You don't have to upgrade his armor or anything like that. You just, you know, display him onto the monument and you're good to go. Now for the rest of the group, so for Jorah, I mean like Ogden, it's not Dorfula, he's Ogden. His name is Ogden. Jorah, this is Gwen. Why is it saying like Vanguard Mesmer? But yeah, this is Gwen, Olias, and you know, Vec, Acolyte Susuke, and yeah, those you need to have a special token, which I will be covering in a separate video. Yeah, this is the honor. This is for the main quest or special dungeon. So I done the Eternal Conqueror. Well, this is my, you know, this is the title anyway, Eternal Conqueror of Ugot's Warren. This one is an elite mission, so it's quite difficult to do even at a normal mode. So I had a separate video for that, so if you want to check that one out, feel free to do so. And this is Hero of Cantha, which is the title that I wear to me when I finish off the faction campaign. This is Hero of Tira, this is for me finishing off my prophecy campaign. I have when finished off the Nightfall campaign on my ritualist, but I think I only had about two more missions to go on Nightfall for that. Now for the resilience, you need to display your armor, I don't have that special armor yet. It's called Prestige in this game. It's called the special armor that you can display onto the Horned Monument. There are two types, one of them is Prestige and the other one they call Obsidian armor. And again, I'll be covering them in the in a separate video. And for the Valor, it's for the weapons, and I will be covering them in a separate video. Because I don't have any of them with me at the moment, but I will do it in a separate video so you know which one is which. I mean the special weapons, because some of them might look, you know, the gold plate might look a little bit similar to that special weapon that you can display, but it's not the same. So you know, I will be doing it in a separate video. So you can have a look at it yourself. Now back to the faction campaign. Now for the Blackmoor, you have to do the quests, about 4 or 5 quests or something like that, and then once it's available you can charm them, and once you charm them it will be level 5. So before you can actually display onto the Horns of Manuman, you need to get it to level 20. So a lot of farming has to be done. So what I would strongly recommend you to do is that once you have the pet, what you can do is that you can take it along with you, and you know, when you start doing like the normal side quests or like what I'm doing at the moment, doing the normal side quests and stuff like that, and once it reached to level 20, I will again show you where you can store it. Before storing it, I will display it onto the Horns of my human, and once I done that, I will store them into the pet zone. That's what I call it. I'm not sure what is a proper term for that, but I did the same for my Phoenix, but I can't really remember the name on top of my head right now. So so until then, I will finish off the quest, capture the Blackmoor, and then I will include in the video where I would be putting it once I got it to level 20. So yeah, that's the background of this quest. So let's get started.
Thank you. Yeah.
So that's pretty much it. I thought that we're gonna have to level up the Blackmore, but it's not really the case since it's only level 20. And once the pet is level 20, you can boot it up onto the Fellowship Monument, and you know, that's pretty much just cover for everything, really. To this play, just go to this and add the statue of the Blackmore. And yep, this is how it's going to be displayed. Done. Now, I guess that out of all of the pet companions, the Imperial Phoenix is the one that you have to level 20, because I did that when I first got it. It was level 5, and so I had to level it up to level 20 before I can display onto here. But for the Blackmore, I don't really have to because it's at level 20. Now there is another pet, and from what I can remember, it's called the Black Widow. And the Black Widow is in one of the elite dungeon. It's called the Underworld, and because of that, you know, it would be strongly advised, according to the Wikipedia, that you know, before you come in, you have to be really prepared. And if you are soloing, you have, you know, it would take you a lot, take you a while to get that, because the Underworld dungeon is not easy, from what I have been told. Alright, so I'll cover that in, you know, in a separate video, of course, but level that up anyway, because it's only level 20 for your Black Widow. So, you know, now that makes the Blackmore to be level 20 upon charming. So I guess that the only work that you have to put into to get the pet for the pet to level to 20 is the Imperial Phoenix, and that's it. The other two, they are, you know, they're not that, you know, you don't have to put any work to get them to level 20, but getting them is another story, especially for the Black Widow versions. So you have to complete a lot of, you know, tasks, quests, missions, and you know main quests and yada yada that stuff to get into the house of Helsa before you can actually get the quest to get the Moa. Now, talk to this guy, Menegi. Sorry, this guy is the guy, Hivala, but he's in this area right here. And the only one way that you can get it into is to go to the ship and select the correct temple of both of them and go to the Zaishen Minagri grounds and talk to the guy in there. And once you go, wait, where the hell is my pet? Oh yeah, I see now. Alright. Yeah, so it's available. And you just have to walk right through. As you can see, this is my Phoenix. It's level 5, but you know, I already make it level 20, but it's just, this one is just, you know, for other characters in my accounts, if they want to get a Phoenix, they're happy to come here and pick it up, and it will be level 20, I believe, but I'm not really sure on that, because you know, I only play one character. I don't play multiple characters that has pets. So you know, well, that's it. And you just have to talk to this Emrit the Tamer. And it just spent my pet collection. Yes, pay 100 gold for any level 20 pet card in the wild. Is my pet collection yet? All right, release the pet more, and voila, it's in here. It's safe. So you know, that's it. You don't have to worry about that anymore. It's safe. It's displayed onto the minion. Yeah, so yeah my Phoenix is here, and yeah, it's taken away off. So you know, I have free pet slot, because I believe that you can only take one of one at a time. And yeah, that's pretty much it. You can take only one at a time, and you cannot take another. But uh But yeah, I mean, like, it's if your purpose is only to get like is display on Honor Monument, so just release it after you send it to the Honor Monument. All right, so that's pretty much it. For the pet more, for those of you who are interested in the Horns of Monument achievement and also for the title. Alright, so I'll see you later then for my other videos that I will talk about some other stuff in regard to the Horns of Monument and also in regard to perhaps God walking among us mortals if you're interested in that. So yeah, I'll see you later.